Shalom and a very good day to you. I am Richard Peretz, and our special show today is dedicated to the mitzvah of building a family. The Jewish wedding, which in Hebrew is not called a wedding, but kiddushim, which means consecration and sanctification. The preservation of Jewish life and heritage, obviously, also depends upon maintaining the Jewish family, which begins with a joyful event of the wedding ceremony. In our program, we shall illustrate this subject by showing a Jewish wedding and what it entails. Today we are also marking the Shalom Show's 5th anniversary. We've been on the air now since April 1979, and I've been persuaded to combine our noting our 5th anniversary on the air with our subject today, the Jewish wedding, by sharing with you my own wedding. We made all the arrangements by ourselves and had no idea how complicated and involved they would be. From the selection of wedding invitations, a guest list, the mikveh ritual baths for the bride, to choosing the wedding rings and more. We had a lot of running around to do.
Richard.
Hey, Phil. Nice to see you. How
nice
are you doing?
To see you again.
This is Yardena.
Hello.
Yardena, it's very
doing?
Nice to meet you.
The subject in question.
The subject.
Yeah.
The bride.
The bride-to-be.
Okay.
Do you have some gowns for her?
Yes, we do. We've picked out
She isn't the largest of brides now.
No, not the smallest either. But we've picked out a couple of styles that will look very nice on it. Patty, the store manager.
Oh, hi.
How are you?
Will be fitting.
This is my bride to be Yardena.
Nice to meet you.
How are you?
This is Phil.
She'll be fitting Yardena. We have a couple styles that Patty's picked out in her size that we think will look very nice on her. And at this point, I guess we'll let Patty take Yardena on the ladies' side.
Absolutely.
Right.
And you and I will make an entrance on the men's tuxedo side.
Great, I could use one.
I just love the neckline.
It's a beautiful look with the sweetheart neckline and the illusion up to the neck. It's very feminine.
How about the train?
The train is just beautiful. It's embroidered daintily. Gives you a nice, ruffled, feminine look.
Right. Good. And the sleeve also.
The sleeves are pretty. They're very different.
Yeah. How about the hair?
Your hair looks beautiful. I like the way you have it pulled up in the halo. And the rosebuds give you that finishing touch. That's just beautiful.
Okay. That's great. I love it.
Okay, let me show you one more that has a little different sleeve and a little different material.
Fine.
Richard, you measure a 40 in a chest. With the pant, I'd say around a 40 short with the arm sleeve measurement. This is just a try-on coat. This is a black tuxedo try-on coat.
This is a tuxedo, interesting.
That is a tuxedo. What you'll be wearing is a black full dress. This is just a coat to get the measurement through the chest.
Probably with tails, tails and all, eh?
That's right.
Oh, it's so beautiful. I don't know which I like more.
I think the other neckline was a little more flattering and feminine with the illusion up to the neck. Do you like the hat?
I like it, but I think the other one is...
It's a little more you. It's cute, it's daintier. Okay, well, there's one more I'd like to show you, so let's go look at that.
Sure, I would love to.
Richard, now that we've chosen your outfit that you'll be wearing...
Oh, I really love the tuxedo you chose for me. I think it's absolutely lovely.
That's the black full dress. That's what's appropriate for that time of the day, and we've also chosen what'll be worn for your father and the best man.
And the bridesmaids and all that, too.
The bridesmaids, the mother of the bride, the flower girl, and I believe that Patty has probably finished up with Yardena at this point.
Here they are right now.
Hello.
How is it? You found a dress?
Yeah. Everything is just great.
You found a headpiece that matched?
Everything.
Everything is good? Yeah,
well, that's fantastic.
Yes.
Very good.
That's marvelous.
Thank you.
Phil, I want to thank you very, very much for
everything. It's my pleasure.
Yardena, of course, would not let me see her dress, which he's keeping as a surprise until the wedding. ¶¶ you Chris?
I'm Chris.
I'm Richard.
How
this is Yardena.
Hello. Oh, you must be the bride to be. How you doing?
Well, certainly is. Oh, we're just fine. She's a little concerned as to what to do with her hair, and I was hoping that maybe she'd do something about it.
Oh, we'd be glad to, and there'll be no problem. Rebecca will take care of you.
Hi. Hello. I'm Rebecca. Glad to meet you.
I'm Richard. Nice to meet you.
Would you like to come on back to my chair, and we'll see what we can do?
Great.
Richard, she's got lovely long hair, and there's many things we can do for her.
I've got no doubt about that.
Would you care for a cup of coffee?
Absolutely love some.
You know, Rebecca, I really don't know what to do with my hair.
Well, if you describe your veil to me, then I can work the hairdo in around the veil.
Okay, so I have a Caesar veil.
A Caesar veil?
Yeah.
Does the veil start from the flowers down?
Yes.
Is it long?
That's right.
Oh,
it's
I have
long,
a great hairdo in mind I could try.
Hi.
Do you like it?
I think it's absolutely lovely.
Thank you. That's the entire list of the arrangements for your wedding now. Did you have any other questions?
No, I think it's...
You must be really proud to be here with your daughter planning her wedding.
It's not my daughter, it's my future daughter-in-law.
I'm sorry.
I just flew in from Israel and I'm still suffering from jet lag.
That's nice. Let me show you one more thing over here. We're going to make your centerpieces for your for the table, something like this with the mixed flowers and very airy mixed.
That's good.
Delicate babies with nothing.
Yeah,
babies,
I know.
Like that.
I think that's very pretty.
Finally, the big day. Temple Emanuel in Miami Beach, where our Rabbi Irving Lehrman would conduct the ceremony.
Son, Vesakala. My dear Yardena and Richard, I can't tell you what a joy it is for me, as your rabbi, to stand here sharing the simcha with you and your wonderful parents and members of the family. Richard, I've always admired you, both as a human being, as a great artist. You've interviewed me quite a few times on television, and I've learned to admire you and respect you. When a man and a woman are worthy of each other, they cause God to dwell in their midst. I know that you're both worthy of each other. This union brings together two lovely young people like you, and also brings together two fine Balabatish families. Beautiful families. Very, very important. This is Thanksgiving weekend. There's much to be thankful for. Your dear ones and friends gathered here are thankful to God because we're privileged to share the Simcha with you. You are thankful to God because God has given you the most precious gift in life, the gift of love. Nothing more beautiful, nothing more sacred than the gift of love. And we pray that this love will blossom like a beautiful flower and bring happiness and fulfillment to your lives, nachas to your dear ones, and blessedness in the house of Israel. You're both young and intelligent and good looking with good background, and the future is yours. Look to the future with optimism, with confidence, with trust and hope. Marriage is a sacred institution. This is why it's called Kiddushin in Hebrew. Kiddushin means holy, kadosh. This is what marriage is all about. It's based on selfless love, on mutual respect and trust and faith, faith in one another, faith in God. This is what marriage is all about. And as you build your lives and you build your home, you have a third partner, God. He's your third partner. And he'll be with you and bless your union with all the gifts of heaven, with life and health and contentment and peace and happiness. We pray that all of us be privileged to bask in the sunshine of your happiness for many years to come. Amen.
Amen.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, borei pri agafeh nefesh. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, asher kirishanu b'mitzvotav. Tzivanu alo arayos, v'yosa lono es arusos, v'hiti lono es anasuos lanu, ayilifu pav kidushin, baruch atah Adonai, v'kadesh amo Yisrael, ayilifu pav kidushin.
Amen.
If you drink of this cup of wine together, so may you drink always of the cup of joy together. Richard, you take Yardena to be your wife, and you promise to love, honor, and cherish her throughout life. If so, will you say, I do?
I do.
Yardena, you take Richard to be your husband. You promise to love, honor, and cherish him throughout life. If so, will you say, I do?
I do.
You will take the marriage ring now and place it upon the finger of the bride.
I take the, okay.
Will you repeat with me as you address the bride, Richard? Hare.
Hare.
Yes, sir. At. Mekudeshet.
Mekudeshet.
Li.
Li.
Bitabat.
Bitabat.
Zu.
Zu.
Kedat.
Kedat.
Moshe.
Moshe.
V'Yisrael.
V'Yisrael.
Be thou wedded unto me.
Be thou wedded unto me
with
this ring
as my wife,
as my wife,
according to the laws of Moses,
according to the laws of Moses,
and the faith of Judaism,
and the faith of Judaism.
And now you will take the companion ring, Yardena.
A companion ring. Oh,
and place it upon the finger of the bridegroom, and say to him the following words, taken from the Song of Songs in the Bible, from Shira Shirim. Ani
ledodi.
I am my beloved.
I am your beloved.
Ledodi li.
Ledodi li.
My beloved is mine.
My beloved.
And now, I'm going to present you with a certificate of marriage. This is a ketubah. It It's written in Hebrew and Aramaic, which is the language of the Talmud. My dear young friends, we're now concluding this ceremony. I know there are many prayers being offered now. Certainly there are silent prayers in your hearts. May God grant fulfillment to all your prayers, to all your dreams and to all your hopes for the future. May God in heaven watch over you and guide you and sustain you and protect you as you walk through life together. May he bless you in the words of our ancient priestly benediction. Yivarechecha Adonai v'yishmerecha. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you and be gracious upon you. May the Lord lift his face unto you and grant you peace, peace in your home, peace and happiness in your lives, peace, shalom, shalom al Israel. Peace unto Israel, unto all of mankind. Amen.
Amen.
And now by virtue of the authority that is vested in me as rabbi, it's with great joy that I pronounce you husband and wife. I will ask you to break the glass with a prayer that all sorrow be broken in your hearts.
Friends moved into a second hall where a reception was being held in our honor. We missed the reception because we were kept busy posing for endless pictures. Finally, we could join our friends and families in the main ballroom for the dinner.
A unique occasion, because not only will there be one toast in English, but there will also be one in Hebrew. This represents a unique affair. There are people here from Canada, from Israel, and from the United States. And if one looks at where we originated from, we probably have representatives from the four corners of the earth. And so, to Richard and his wonderful bride, I have for you only one wish, and that is that I wish that all the wishes you have for yourself come true.
We were honored by the presence of many distinguished guests who joined us in celebrating our happy event.
Though we gotta say goodbye for the summer, darling, I promise you this, I'll send you all my love every day in a letter sealed with a kiss. Guess it's gonna be a cold.
We took our first dance to one of Yardena's favorite tunes.
But I'll fill the emptiness, I'll send you all my dreams every day in a letter.
The sharing of happy moments shared with one's friends and families will remain treasured together with the words of our rabbi during the ceremony. The wedding cake symbolizes the sweetness of life to follow.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam borei peri hagafen. You both take Chazak uvaruch. Mazal tov.
Shemereni,
Just as in our Jewish tradition, God gave a promise to his people, Israel, so do we pledge ourselves to each other in marriage, as expressed in these verses from the book of Hosea. I will betroth you to myself forever in righteousness and in justice, in kindness and in mercy. I will betroth you unto myself in faithfulness, and you shall know the Lord. We'll be back next week as usual with our regular programming. Have a lovely day.
And thank you for being with us.
Man nam cha batem aleka, mishnerom